days are never ending, when the nights are feeling lonely. There's a place that I can go, where the birds are free to roam. In the sky, flying high, over fields of green. And where the stars inside the sky, where the last ones shine and bright. Pushing through the storm tonight, we'll be burning on and on and on. Where the stars inside the sky, we're the last ones shining bright. Pushing through the storm tonight, we'll be burning on and on and on.
Hello Gemini. This is Inspire 2016 with your weekly tarot reading for the week commencing the 16th of October until the 22nd of October 2017. The first card for you is representing, how do you feel about yourself? Your card is the Four of Cups. You are dissatisfied with the status quo. You may be feeling disengaged, apathetic, or unmotivated. Life has become stale or flattened. There is little that excites you anymore. To overcome this, the Four of Cups suggests a need to re-evaluate your situation and to look deep within your own psyche to find understanding and meaning. Turn your attention inward to find the truth for which you are searching. Avoid distractions and examine your heart and mind to gain clarity. There might be an offer has been presented to you, but you are holding off making any sort of decision or evaluation of that opportunity until you have had more time for reflection and consideration. Notice that while the man in this card has not accepted the offer being presented to him, he has not completely rejected it either. The cup will continue to be there, and the decision to accept or reject it can be made at any point. For now, though, it is the time for contemplation, research and meditation. When all of the answers are in, and it feels right emotionally, then you can take action, but in the short term, you do not need to make an immediate choice. Similarly, the Four of Cups signifies disappointment in someone or in a situation. You may be growing tired of the same old struggle that has been carried on too long in the past. As a result, you have started to withdraw and go within yourself to seek greater peace and tranquility. If you are becoming particularly pouty or sulky about your predicament, the Four of Cups is then a call to action. It is time to wake up, be alert and to be open to new experiences that offer a more positive outcome. The Four of Cups can sometimes point to defensiveness. This can be noticed in the body language displayed in the crossed arms and legs of the man on the card. He chooses to ignore the possibility of what the cup has to offer. Possibly he has been hurt emotionally before, as this is the Suit of Cups, and he is fearful to expose himself to that again, hence he is closing himself off to this opportunity. Consider what opportunities you are ignoring or declining, and ask yourself whether this is because you truly believe you would not benefit from it, or whether this is because you are fearful of what may follow. Be mindful of any defensiveness in your responses and reactions. The second card for you is representing, what do you want most right now? Your card is the Queen of Cups. What do you want most right now is to empathize with others and to show true compassion. Focus on the emotional well-being of others rather than relying on rational or logical explanation. You are here to support and to teach others, by drawing upon your own intuition and sense of calm and emotional connectedness. Learn how those in need cope with life's challenges and share your knowledge. Hug someone you care about. The Queen of Cups can manifest as a person in your life or as a part of yourself. There might be a mature female significant figure in your life, most likely from water signs. She is often like a mirror, reflecting the hidden depths of others back to them, so they can see their own mysteries for themselves. Thus, The Queen of Cups indicates that you need to trust your intuition and listen to your inner voice. Trust the sensations and the feelings you are getting from your outside environment. One of the greatest assets of the Queen of Cups is her ability to sense the needs of those around her. Due to her associations with the element of water, the Queen of Cups can be passive and receptive. Her sensitivity draws those who struggle and suffer towards her. In many ways, she is a safe harbor for others. Her ability to connect on a soul level enables her to remedy the broken hearts of others. Her warmth and genuine caring make her a beacon of light. Because she is so responsive to the feelings of others, the Queen of Cups must constantly uphold her boundaries between herself and others. If not properly protected, the Queen of Cups can lose her own sense of self. This is her greatest vulnerability. The Queen of Cups tends to think with her heart, rather than her head. She may lack common sense and rationality, but she is highly intuitive and sometimes psychic and dreamy. Similarly, if you are finding that the logical approach is not working, then the Queen of Cups encourages you to follow your heart and not your mind. You may be required to turn inward and explore your emotions about a particular situation. The Queen of Cups symbolizes achievements made possible by the use of imagination and creativity. This is a woman who is highly imaginative and artistically gifted, affectionate and romantic in outlook. She is often involved in creative or literary pursuits, and enjoys art, good music, literature and things of beauty. Therefore, you may be more inclined to pursue creative projects, particularly if it acts as a form of self-expression. The third card for you is representing your fears. Your card is the Five of Cups. You are afraid that a situation has not turned out as you had hoped. However, you are beginning to realize the full implications of the past and you have come to appreciate the lessons learned from the experience. You may even recognize the value of the painful experience in the broader scheme of things in preparing you for later experiences. You are ready to pick up the remaining two cups that are full of the water of emotional growth and go on. This card is also about learning to be open and to take risks again. It is a card of a lingering sense of regret, nostalgia and bittersweet memories, but the card itself speaks of being hopeful for the future, getting over whatever you need to get over, and of seeing the sun peek through the clouds once again. If you have suffered a broken romance, the Five of Cups signifies an end to the suffering, and a beginning to new loves and relationships, new interests, and new emotional outlets. You are starting to engage with the inspiring, creative and feeling side of life again. The Five of Cups is about values and knowing what you truly want and what will really make you happiest. It is about the hidden blessings that lie behind obvious disappointments. Sometimes disappointments are required to see through illusions and free you to find what is truly of value in life. Once you have made this transition, you will be free to embrace new opportunities. Sometimes, the Five of Cups indicates a feeling of being trapped in the past, holding on too tightly to the might-have-beens, and not being able to focus on the positive. The reversal could also indicate buried feelings of regret that you are not allowing to surface and therefore they never get dealt with and brought to closure. 5 is also the number of change, and indicates an emotional destabilization that is intended to create change in how you approach your life. The fourth card for you is representing what is going for you. Your card is the 8 of Wands. You are so sure about your goal that all distractions have been removed and you can devote yourself to the task with complete concentration, determination, and will. This experience can be very productive, allowing you to accomplish a lot in short time. With the Eight of Wands, you can look forward to the rapid completion of a project that is currently underway, but you can also expect to be occupied by something new and even more exciting and inspiring very soon. There really is no stopping you right now, as you are just bursting with energy and ideas, and cannot wait to achieve one task in order to start another. To maximize this energy, it is important to ensure that your activities are focused on your broader goals and that you are investing in the right things at the right time. Also, make sure that before you move to the next task, your previous task is complete. This card is a sign to strike while the iron is hot. It is most definitely an action-oriented card that encourages you to move quickly to pursue the best opportunities available right now. There is no waiting around while the Eight of Wands is present, so determine where your energy will be directed and get on with it. Often, the Eight of Wands suggests air travel. It is more likely to be a short-term or whirlwind trip, such as a business trip or holiday. You may even enjoy being part of a tour group that visits 10 countries in as many days. On the downside, the Eight of Wands denotes haste and rapid advancement of a situation which may result in the wrong decisions being made. It will be important to have all your resources available to be used in your best interests. Be mindful not to rush into things without having a clear plan of where you are heading. The fifth card for you is representing what is going against you. Your card is the Three of Pentacles. There is a lack of teamwork, whereby people are acting in competition with each other and trying to appear the most knowledgeable. You may be trying to work collaboratively with others, but there is an increasing level of tension as each individual tries to exert power or control over the group, thus negatively impacting the harmony of the people involved. If you rely on the cooperation of others, now may be a good time to break free of your current group or network and join forces with another group. The lack of harmony and teamwork is having a negative impact on your performance, and there may be a lack of a common goal. It may be best to just move on at this stage. The Three of Pentacles signifies that you are seeking more respect in the workplace. You have had to be polite and listen to the opinions and feedback of your superiors, but now you seem to be growing restless with always taking the advice, rather than giving it. You want to work in an environment where you have the chance to voice your own opinion and be heard, where you are seen as the expert or the leader. You may also be seeking new colleagues who bring with them new knowledge, so as to create a more synergistic team environment. You might be working in a fairly mundane job, in which your contributions and experience are not really appreciated or valued. There is not much opportunity for growth and advancement, and you feel as if your skills and capabilities are not being effectively utilized. It may be a good time to make a career move and find somewhere where your skills are more valued. All in all, if you do not have a clear view of how you will accomplish your goals, then it will be beneficial to stop working momentarily and plan out your next steps at a detailed level. The last card for you is representing the likely outcome that you may have. Your card is the Nine of Pentacles. You have worked hard to get here, so now, sit back and relax and enjoy some of life's luxuries. You deserve it. Do not be afraid to splurge, indulge or pamper yourself, particularly if it is as a reward for all of your hard work. Treat yourself to a special occasion, to simply celebrate the journey you have been on to achieve your goals and to re-energize yourself for the next phase. You are close to reaching completion, so acknowledge this and then prepare for what will come after. Sometimes, however, the Nine of Pentacles can indicate that you are close to reaching your goal but you have not yet made it. So, as a result, you may want to stick to your program and continue sacrificing until you have reached that goal. You are showing great self-discipline and self-control to ensure you get to where you want to be. Whilst the Suit of Pentacles typically focuses on material wealth and gain, the Nine of Pentacles also suggests that you are in harmony with the nature that is around you. You have an appreciation for the beauty and abundance found in nature, and you are able to harness this energy to bring pleasure into your life. You may enjoy gardening or floristry, or you may simply like to pass your time in the beauty of nature with picnics or walks in the park. The Nine of Pentacles can indicate a time of restraint, poise and grace. The figure in the card is very ladylike and refined. She lives a comfortable, luxurious lifestyle and is able to keep herself looking nice. This is a time when you need to carry yourself with grace and refinement, and to be tactful and diplomatic in your dealings with others. Last but not least, the guidance card for you is the Golden Atlantean Dragon. This card invites you to activate your own personal fifth dimensional blueprint, for it contains the light of the incredible era of Golden Atlantis. The Golden Atlantean Dragon, who has come to you now, worked directly with all the great masters of Atlantis during the Halcyon days and remembers exactly who you truly are. Prepare to reclaim your mastery. You are ready to dissolve the final veils of amnesia, and your dragon will assist you to do so. Ask it to breathe its golden fire into your third eye so that the final clearance and awakening can take place. Your dragon will then remain with you and shine light into you as you prepare to stand in your power as an Atlantean master.
I hope that you enjoy everything, and if you like the reading, just please click subscribe and you will get instant notifications every time we publish a new video right to your YouTube. Thanks.